Hi everyone, welcome to another DevTest Community Webcast. Thank you for joining. Today our topic is the LDAP and Active Directory integration for DevTest. Today we have Surya giving the presentation and we will be pausing for questions every once in a while. If you have any questions during the session, you can enter them into the Q&A box in the bottom right-hand corner, and we'll get to them as soon as we can. We'll also open the line up for verbal questions at the end, so if you have a question that you feel would be better asked over the phone, you can hold it until the end of the session, and we'll open up the line. I'm now going to turn the call over to Surya. Take it away, Surya.
Thanks, Melanie. Hello, all. Good morning. This is Surya, and I'm a senior architect with engineering services team, and I'm part of the customer advocacy team. As part of this team, we go to customers and help them with best practices, and we review their architecture and provide recommendations, etc. So we'll talk about LDAP, Active Directory integration for DevTest. Let's dive right in. This will be the agenda. We'll talk about user authentication and authorization. That we'll look at how authentication and authorization is implemented in DevTest, then challenges with the ACL, with the existing system, then solution, then LDAP AD integration with DevTest, and why do we need this, how this works, and how do we configure this. And then we'll go ahead with a demo followed by the Q&A. Okay, so user authentication and authorization. So what exactly is authentication? You know, it's basically validating a person who says that he is who he is, right? So it is basically to validate, in terms of application terms, you know, it's about validating the user who logs in. Then we have authorization. Okay, so the person says, you know, who he is, but then what all can he actually access or what actions can he perform? That is where authorization comes into picture, where you verify the access to perform a certain action. For example, you know, if you look at DevTest as such, you know, there are a lot of actions that you can perform. You know, we have app test related actions, virtual service related actions, administration related actions. So there are a lot of actions. So just to verify, you know, who can do what. So that is where authorization comes into picture. So it is important definitely to prevent unauthorized access or usage, and which I'm sure you all agree in an organization. So these are definitely also important aspects of DevTest. And you know, key aspects of DevTest as we learn, you know, through the course of the presentation. So, how is user authentication authorization implemented in DevTest? So, in DevTest, we have what is called as a role-based access control. It is known as ACL. And ACL, you know, in essence, comprises of users and roles. And you know, we have the screenshots of how ACL is on the right side. So I mean, it's not that clear, but I'll show it as part of the demo. But so what it really consists of is the users who log in, and then each user can then be assigned a role. And a role is what actually controls the permissions. You know, roles have permissions, and these permissions are defined for various actions or activities. For example, you know, if you look at a virtual service deployment or, you know, staging a test, so these are all different actions. There are a lot of other actions. View privileges, then deploy privileges, edit privileges, etc. Right. So all of these, you know, require permissions, and you can control permissions for all of these actions through the roles. And so ACL was optional in the earlier versions of DevTest or Lisa, but right now it's enabled by default from DevTest 8.0. It was optional for older versions. And if you, you know, for the versions, you know, from, you know, you can actually access, you know, via settings in the portal, you can go to the settings, and you know, when you click on access control is when you can, you know, do that. And if you are on an older version, you can go into administration on your, you know, server console, and you can see the ACL under that. And the ACL data is basically stored in the database. You know, it is stored in your DevTest DB. Now, if you are using the default database, which comes packaged with DevTest, it will be stored in DB. If you are using like an enterprise database or an external database like Oracle or SQL Server, it will be stored in that. So basically, that's where ACL data gets stored, or the user data and the roles data gets stored. So what are some of the challenges with ACL? So, you know, let's say your organization has an existing LDAP which you use to log into your applications, etc. you know, if you don't integrate, you know, if you are using ACL separately, you will have to have separate passwords for logging into DevTest also, and it is managed within ACL. So you have two different set of passwords, one for which with which you log into all of your applications, then another with which you log into ACL, which is okay if it's a small set of group. But then let's say you have a large organization where, you know, number of users are using DevTest, you'll have to also maintain the passwords for all of them. And if you know, 10 users want to change their password or 20 users want to change their password, so you have a lot of maintenance there in terms of the passwords. And also in terms of addition of users, you know, you'll have to manually add the users. You know, that's another challenge. And also the user maintenance, right? So, you know, adding, you know, basically in terms of the user maintenance also, you know, it can be a challenge, especially if it's a large organization. So what is the solution, you know, with for these challenges? Solution is, you know, to integrate with an existing authentication mechanism. And, you know, it should work in conjunction with ACL, because ACL is where really you're controlling the role and the access privileges, right? So it should work in conjunction with ACL. And, you know, so this will, this system integration would enable a centralized management of the passwords, like the users and the passwords, the customer passwords of the users. So in terms of LDAP AD integration with DevTest, so what it really involves is it involves integration with an existing LDAP or an Active Directory based system, which again, predominantly most of the organizations have this implemented. So you can integrate with this existing LDAP or AD based system. And it helps, you know, it basically enables LDAP administrator to manage, you know, the passwords and the users, right? So this way, you know, user passwords are no longer managed through ACL. So it is managed by LDAP admin, and it will be the same password which you use to log into any of your internal applications which support LDAP. It's the same password that you use to log into DevTest also. So it will ensure integration into an existing user management system. Okay, so why do we need this? You know, we spoke about definitely, you know, if you have a large number of users, you know, maintaining the passwords, et cetera, can be an overhead. So integration, you know, will take advantage of the existing system, and, you know, it definitely helps save effort, right? I mean, you know, the overload of, you know, maintaining the passwords, et cetera, you can save that effort. And, you know, you would use the same passwords for both LDAP and DevTest, which makes it easier. And, you know, it's also easier to configure and maintain. You know, it has auto add user feature also. We'll talk about that, where, you know, once a user logs in, you know, authenticates through LDAP, you know, it will automatically add the users into DevTest ACL. So we'll look into how that actually works, this whole flow. We'll look into that. How does this work? So this is typically, and I tried to put together a kind of a flow to explain how it works. So, you know, you have your DevTest user base, and they typically log into DevTest, you know, either workstation or a portal, right? So there, you know, what we do is we have a file that is packaged called authentication providers.xml. In that, what you do is you will basically configure the LDAP or the AD server related details and the configuration. So based on that, when a user logs in initially, the authentication will happen at the LDAP or the AD server, just like how it happens for your, you know, in-house applications. So based on the settings here, when you log in, the authentication will happen against the LDAP server. And once you are successfully authenticated is when you'd be authorized at the DevTest ACL. So based on the user details, you know, based on your LDAP group, it can be mapped to an existing DevTest role. A role can be, let's say, super user or DevTest admin, or we're talking about SV power user or test power user or just a user, test runner, all of these different roles, right? So you can map them to existing LDAP user groups. So for example, let's say you have an LDAP user group called administrator. You can map that administrator with, let's say, DevTest admin within DevTest role. So you can map those, directly map the ADS, I mean the LDAP group with DevTest user role. And this mapping happens at LDAPmappings.xml file. We will definitely look into these in detail. You know, when I go into the demo, I will show those files and how the configuration looks. So this is where you do that. And based on this, user will be authorized based on the role-based access. You know, he'll be able to authorize to do certain functions, whichever he's allowed to in DevTest. So this is kind of like the high-level flow of how this this integration works. And yeah, so in case you could add multiple mappings, obviously. For example, let's say there is a super user DevTest role, you can map multiple LDAP groups. We will talk about that in the coming slides, and I'll show you that in the demo. How do we configure this? Now we have an older method. You know, I was talking about LDAP. Are you able to hear me clearly?
Sir, I can hear you. I'll work with Cassiano to see what the problem is.
Oh, sure. All right. Just wanted to make sure. Okay. So the older method was, where we used to configure the LDAP-related settings in local.properties. So properties like, the LDAP URL that you have, then the user and the credentials for accessing the LDAP server, then the base context and the user's search filter, we'll take a look at those. And, the default role. So when a user gets added, gets authenticated at LDAP, what would be the default role with which he'll be added? So these were the settings. And there was no mapping with LDAP groups in the older method. It was simple user, gets authenticated and he gets added to, DevTest ACL. For this to work, you'll have to remove or comment the ACL auth enabled property. So this is what you need to do, and then make these LDAP settings. That is when it will integrate with LDAP. Now this is an older method that we have, but again, so the newer method is definitely in a way, much more, it makes it much more easier in terms of maintenance. So let's move on to learn more about the newer method that we have. So I think starting 8.4 DevTest, we have this integration where you have two files, authentication providers XML and LDAP mappings XML. So the files are, as you can see on the screen, the authentication providers XML is where you configure the LDAP related settings. Similar settings, basically the LDAP URL, then the user, DN, the directory, and then, the password and, the pattern, the filters to match the, find the users, and then the group information and how to search for the group's information, all that basically. These LDAP related settings go into authentication providers XML. So you can work with your, if you want to implement LDAP integration, you can work with your LDAP admin who will have a better understanding of the settings and you can get them configured. So the default, the file which comes packaged with DevTest has a template for all of these settings. You could use that and then make modifications according to your requirement and how your system is implemented. So in terms of providers, it supports LDAP as a provider, then Active Directory as a provider, and you also have a custom provider. So these are different providers that are supported. Now, so this is where you are providing authentication related details. Again, once the user gets authenticated, then comes the LDAP mappings file into picture where, so when the user gets authenticated, it looks up the user group, LDAP group. So based on that LDAP group, it can be mapped against a DevTest ACL user role. For example, I don't know if you can see this, but there is like a super user mapping role here, right? So you're mapping it to DevTest admin group here. I mean, just on a sample file, but you could actually map them like that. So you can actually map multiple LDAP groups to single user role within DevTest ACL, basically ACL user roles, all of these. So this is how the new system works. All right. So now that we've learned about how the system works and how the settings are configured, managed, etc., let's get into a demo where I will actually show you the files and how the integration works. So let me start sharing my screen.
And just a reminder, guys, while Sirius shares his screen, if you want to minimize or maximize that view, there are controls over at the top right-hand corner of the display screen that will control your personal view. Sorry, go ahead, Sirius.
No problem, Melanie. All right. So, you know, I was talking about the LDAP, the ACL settings. So this is DevTest 10. If you go into settings, access control, that is where you have the roles and users. Let's look into this a little. In terms of roles, these are all the different roles that we have in DevTest: super user, DevTest administrator, test administrator, system administrator, SP power, and you know all of the different roles. In each of these roles, when you select them, it shows you the permissions that the user has. Right, so super user has all the permissions, as you can see. And let's say you're looking at SP power, there are some limitations in terms of what SP power user can do. And this gives you the permission details and also the users who are currently assigned this particular role. You can get those details also here. Now, you know, these are definitely out of box user roles, you know, which you can assign to the users. But let's say none of these out-of-box user roles actually meet your requirement. And if you want a custom, you know, role to be defined, you know, to provide custom access to certain features, you can always do that. You know, you can go in here and add a role, type in all the details. You know, you could type in the name, let's say custom role, and then provide a description. And then here you can actually assign whatever, you know, you want the user to perform. Right, so you can add the permissions that you'd want the user to have and then save, and the new user role gets created. I'm just discarding that, but you know, you can actually do that way. Now, so you have all the user roles defined, and you can also define a custom user role. Let's get into users. So this is where you have the actual users information. So for example, you have a user called admin. Now you can see that the admin was assigned a super user role. So if you'd want you know, this user to have some other role, you could always select a role and click on here and add, and it will get added. So it just depends on how you want the user to be configured. And with, you know, let's say out of box, you know, without any integration with LDAP, you know, you'll have to actually add the users here. You know, and you know, you basically click on add user, provide all the details of the user, and provide the role that the user needs to have. And that's how you add new users into the system. So out of box, definitely, you know, there is no there is no automated way, right? So you are manually adding the users. So this is basically how the ACL configuration is. Now let's look at, you know, how do we actually get to integrate this with LDAP. So all right. So if you see, this is authentication providers.xml. Now this is available in your Lisa home. If you go into your DevTest home, inside your DevTest home, you'll have it as underscore authentication providers. You'll have to remove the underscore and then, you know, configure the file. That's when it becomes active. And then you can add the settings there. So like I said, you know, you have the template you can use and then customize it to your needs. And it explains what each of the field, you know, inside this template, you know, really means, you know, what it basically references, you know, what that property really is. So I have configured an authentication provider in my machine based on a local instance that I have. And this is an LDAP user, you know, type. So I have added it as LDAP. Now auto add users. So auto add users is where, let's say, an user authenticates successfully with LDAP, then if you enable auto add users, the user will also get added into your ACL system. So you don't have to manually go and click on add user, right? It automatically gets added into ACL. So that's what this property is. Now if you don't want users to be automatically added, you can make it false and pre-add the users. So you'll have to manually add users if the user auto add is false, right? If you make it true, it automatically gets added. Then, you know, authenticate only is another thing where, you know, if you just want the user to be, you know, just authenticated, you could then, you know, enable this or, you know, disable this. Then, of course, enabled is true. Then the type is LDAP and the default role. So when a user gets added, you know, what is the default role? For example, let's say if the user is not mapped, then what is the default role that you want the user to have? So this is where, you know, you give the default role. Now, this default role will be provided only if you make reject unmapped users as false. So what this really means is, we'll get into LDAP mappings where we are mapping the LDAP users to existing user roles, right? Let's say I have a different LDAP group, which is sample. Let's say sample is the group name. Now sample is not mapped to any of the dev test roles. If it is not mapped, that is an unmapped user, right? So if you say reject unmapped users true, that means if a user is not already mapped to any of the, the LDAP groups, if they are not already mapped to a dev test role, the user will not be allowed to log in. So if I say this, that, you know, the reject unmapped user is false, what happens is, let's say the user is not part of any of the existing mappings of the group, then he'll be assigned a default role and he'll get added into dev test. I will show you the example of this, you know, how this works. In addition to that, of course, the regular settings where you have the LDAP URL, then the user DN, the user password basically for the system, and then you have the pattern for searching for the users, and search base, basically the tree where, you know, you want to search, in the search filter, depending on the class of the object and, you know, the DN to be used basically to search, and then the group search base and the filter for searching within the group. So like I said, these settings you can work with your LDAP admin to get them configured based on the template that we have. So really here we are configuring all of the settings related to the LDAP. Now let's get into LDAP mappings. Mappings, like I mentioned, is where, see, all of these are the mapping, each one corresponds to the dev test roles, super user, dev test administrator. We saw all of these roles, right, in the LDAP screen. So you can map them to LDAP groups. For example, in my LDAP system, I have dev test super is one of the user groups which I have configured here. In dev test SV power is what I have configured here. Now it needn't be a custom, you know, new group created in LDAP. It can be an existing LDAP group, meaning let's say your organization already has an LDAP group called administrators. And if you would want all of them to get, you know, super user access, you can assign it. So basically, you'll have to figure out how to map your LDAP groups to dev test user roles. And also, you know, again, like I said, you have to figure out if a user is not already mapped and tries to log in, do you want to add him or not add him, right? And if you want to add him, what will be the default role? All of those you configure here, like we discussed. So I will, explain this through the, in the demo right now, and I'll try configuring users at login, and I'll show that so it's much more clearer. And what I have here is the ACL log. This is where, you know, this is again in your Lisa TMP folder, right? As you can see the path. So here is where you can see the logs, which will help you debug in case of, you know, certain user does not log in or something happens. You can actually debug what's happening. And yes, so here these mappings, you can make them on the fly. You don't necessarily have to restart the process. You know, it will pick up these setting changes. So that's another cool thing about this. Okay, so let me bring up my LDAP system that I have. So I have different users, right? SUR, SU06, this is a super user which is already there. Then I have two different users, you know, just to demonstrate. A user called JDO1. Now this user is assigned to DevTest SV power. And this DevTest SV power is an LDAP group, right? And this has one user, JDO1. This SV power group is assigned to SV power, ACL role. Okay, so this is the ACL role SV power, and this LDAP group is assigned to this one. Now let's try to log in, and just to let you know, I have auto add users as true. So if you look at ACL today, in terms of users, Jado one is not already there. You know, he's not added already. But I have auto add users as true. Let's try adding the, try logging in as Jado one. So what I'm doing is now Jado one is the user that I have. I'm trying to log in. Okay, so he was able to log in. That is because we already have the user map, and we have auto add user as enabled. So let me check that, verify that. I'm logging it with my super user to verify, you know, if the user got added or not. So this is let me show one more thing. So this is one use case that we have. Another use case I have is where I use a sample user, and the sample user is assigned to a group called sample users, right? And this group is not already mapped. So this group is not mapped. So this is the second use case that we'll try. Quickly enable the login. Get back to the settings here. So when I log in, I'll show you the. So when I tried to log in as, let's say, SQRSU, and it was able to find out that I'm part of the DevTest super user group, and automatically add users enabled. But the user is already there. It was able to log in automatically. Then for Jado one. For Jado one, it checked the system, and it found out that it is authentication is the provider is this, and it was able to search for the user, and then found out that this user is of the group DevTest SV power, and automatically adding user is enabled. So that's how the user got added. And, so this is how you can actually debug this whole flow. Let me bring up the this screen to show the whole thing. Bear with me. Okay. All right. So I mean, let me just see if I can quickly. The screen actually kind of froze, so I'm trying to bring up the system. My apologies for that. Let me see if we can.
Sorry, do you want to open it up for questions while you're waiting for it to resolve?
Yes, I think that would be better, and I can definitely take up questions. And I'm actually trying to just restart the system. I mean, restart the process.
Okay. So while we wait for that, we have two questions. I'm not sure if you answered the first already, but Harsha asks, does this file have to be updated whenever there's a change of password? Did you get to that?
No. So these files don't store the passwords, right? So the password maintenance happens at the LDAP server end. Right? Just like, so that is maintained by your LDAP administrator. So in this file, all you are adding is the roles, the LDAP groups and mapping to the roles. That's all that you have here. So you don't have to change the passwords. Now if you're talking about the main and the user to log into LDAP system, if the user changes, yes, I mean the password, that is in the authentication settings, you'll have to change that. In authentication settings, if the main user password changes, you'll have to change that, but then otherwise, that should remain the same.
Okay. We have another question in from Harsha. What's the default role the users get if we enable auto add users?
So if you enable auto add users, you have to mention what the default role is. If you don't mention anything, I think the default role is still the user, but you'll have to manually add. Let me see if there's a... It's again, like I said, all of that is mentioned here. So this is the role, like I said, default role is what you assign if they don't have any other roles assigned, right? So that's where, you provide that default role. If you look at the template, the default is, SP power, if I'm not wrong. Maybe I made the change. But yeah, so you can definitely configure whichever the user wants here, and that will be the default role that the user gets. Do we have any other questions?
Not right now. We'll pause again at the end for more questions.
Right. Yeah. And I see, right, so one question I see is, let's say LDAP authentication is enabled. Then previously, let's say you have a user, like for example, admin or some default user. Can they still access the system? The answer is no, because what happens is, when you authenticate, not the same password. The users will be there, but you cannot use the same password because password management is no longer in ACL, right? So, for example, in ACL, let's say you have admin. When you try to log in as admin next time, once LDAP is enabled, when you log in as admin, it actually validates your password in your LDAP user group, right? So there, if admin has some other password, you cannot log in with admin. So you need to make sure, that the user, that you are logging in. I mean, the password, before you enable, you need the default users. Again, like I said, may not work because that user will have to be there in your LDAP user groups to work. Okay, so I just brought up the portal. Let me quickly show that. So as you can see here, Jado got added. And as you can see, SV power is what we assigned to Jado, and that's what got added, right? So let me log in as, what was the user? I think Sample was the user. Sample was the user, and this time we don't have a mapping, right? Because Sample is part of, if you see, let me bring that up. Sample is part of sample users group, right? And sample users group is something which we have not mapped. We don't have a mapping for sample users group. This is an unmapped user, and I have enabled reject as false. So he will not be rejected, but he'll be given the default role of user, and he can, you know, he will log in. So now sample has logged as a default user. As you can see, very restricted because he does not, he logged in as a, I mean, we will verify that the user got added. We're going to, oops. Yeah. All right, so if you look at users, if you see here sample, yeah, right here. So sample got added, but then if you look at the user type, it's user because it's an unmapped user, and we, since we are not rejecting, he is able to log in. But let's say if I say reject unmapped users true, then sample will not be able to log in because he's not already mapped in any of this. His group is not mapped, he will not be able to log in. But since I said reject as false and auto add as true, is getting added. Let's say if you say auto add as false, you need to make sure before the user logs in, the user has to be added already in the user here. Once you add it here only, he'll be able to log in because auto add is false. But if you have auto add true, user will automatically be added to ACL also. So these are the three different use cases I wanted to demo. And as you can see, as I was logging in, all of those you know, logs are here, so you can clearly see the sample is logged in, and where is that? So he's part of sample users group, and then you know he got added. So likewise, you know, you could use this log. ACL log is useful for debugging any of the ACL related, you know, settings and changes, etc. Let me see if I have any other further questions.
Yeah, we do have quite a few follow-up questions. One is Lafa asks, does DevTest support SSO as well?
Single sign-on, I'll have to get back on that, you know, on this time. But if you look at the providers, you know, LDAP and Active Directory are definitely supported. I'll have to verify if single sign-on is supported.
Okay. We have a question from Ramakrishna. Can we assign different roles even if multiple users belong to the same group?
Multiple users belong to the same group. So what can happen is in that case, you know, let's say when they get added, you can provide them a certain role to start with, but then using DevTest, you can change the role anytime. Meaning, let me see if I can bring that up. So let's say, you know, all of these users got added. Now sample is by default logged in with user, but you can control the user role here. For example, let's say you have 10 different users of the same group. When they all log in, you can give them, let's say, SV power by default. But then on the fly, you know, once the users are added here, you can manually change the user roles. Or you can pre-add all of those users. You can add them prior to logging in itself. You can add the user and give them the required roles. But authentication will happen at LDAP end. But once they log in, like I said, user roles is controlled in ACL. The authorization is controlled in ACL. You know where they, which basically once the user is added, you can control what role he needs to have. It needn't be user. I mean, I can change sample's user role from user to something else, and that's what will stay. But still, sample is getting authenticated at the LDAP itself. So that's how it works. So yes, you can do that, you know, within the same group, different, but that not like, but that is something which you'll have to make changes within DevTest.
Okay, we have another question. Is it correct that there are no local users once LDAP is configured?
I mean, the users will be there, but what happens is, for example, let's say you have admin, the user is still there, as you can see here. But when I log in, you cannot use the password which DevTest has because that is, it's no longer, passwords are no longer maintained in DevTest, right? So let's say you have a user called admin in your LDAP system. That password is what you need to enter. The LDAP password is what you need to enter, not the DevTest password. So the default users, you cannot log in with their whatever password you have set in your any user. For example, let's say I have for example admin. Let's say you have changed the password and you're logging in with DevTest password. But since you enabled LDAP, this password will be maintained at the LDAP level. So that's where you need to make sure you use that password, the LDAP password, to log in for this user.
Okay. Just to let you know, sir, you're not showing your screen, so I'm not sure if you were trying to display anything, but just wanted to let you know. Okay. We have another question in from Stefan. Why adding LDAP users to DevTest at all? Is it just needed for non-LDAP users? So he's asking, why would you add LDAP users to DevTest at all? Is it just needed for non-LDAP users?
No, no. So basically the reason why you will add LDAP users to DevTest is because, you're basically maintaining the users in LDAP, right? So if you have a large organization, I was just talking about, let's say you have 100 different users, different groups. Instead of manually adding all those 100 in DevTest, when you enable auto-add users as true, which they log in with their LDAP login, and it's authenticated and it is mapped, it will by default get added. So you don't have to manually add the users, right, when you enable auto-add. So it will be LDAP users that you add. So if you enable LDAP, the user has to be present in the LDAP system for, when you're enabling LDAP, the user has to be present to log in. So it is actually that's better that way, because you are managing it centrally at LDAP level, all the users, and you're controlling it there. Whichever user you want, you can add to the LDAP group, and then they'll be able to access DevTest with the required with the privilege that you have mapped to that. So yes.
Okay. Joel asks, does the LDAP functionality provide support for mixed mode credentials similar to features provided by DBMS? This way, and DevTest admin always has the back door to get into DT.
Back door to get into, the admin still has to, basically there is definitely some means of editing it, outside of, basically the LDAP. You can actually always go into the database and, I wouldn't recommend that, but then you can definitely make changes that you need. You can add users, remove users, etc. And so you can add multiple providers also, but then when you add multiple providers, when I said providers, we were talking about LDAP providers here, right? Authentication providers. You can add multiple providers, but it will be executed in the order in which you add. So let's say LDAP is on the top, it will always first try to authenticate with LDAP. That's how the whole thing works. And you can, like I said, you can have a custom authentication. As you can see here, if you will have to build a custom authentication, you can use an type, and you can probably achieve what you are talking about. So definitely there are ways. And like I said, if you want to just edit the user information outside of the ACL system, we have ways. But then I said I wouldn't recommend that, directly tweaking the database, because it can corrupt the database, right? So, but yeah, there are ways in which you can edit the user's information outside of console also, the portal. Yeah, and like I said, and also add multiple authentication providers and custom providers, so you can definitely tweak. It needn't be the default one, you can change.
Okay, thanks, Sharia. We have another question from Ramakrishna. Do the dev test need the system or user ID to be connected to LDAP for authenticating users?
Yes, it does. So that's basically what I'm configuring. If you see here, you have the user DNN and password, right? So this is basically the user which I'm using to connect to the LDAP system. So you need a user definitely to connect to the LDAP system. And then you can provide the search base and filter based on which it will look up users. If you see, I have sample, JADE01, SQR, SQ, all of those users, it's able to look up based on the search filter, right? Based on the UID and type of the filter, and search base is this. And that's how I have configured it. So it has to match accordingly. So if you see users, I have all these UIDs, that's how it is searching. But then basically for DevTest to connect to the system and log in, you require a user and password.
Okay. Stefan is looking for a little bit more clarity around the question he asked before. He's not really clear on why you need the users in DevTest from LDAP. He's saying, if the users are maintained in LDAP and the LDAP groups are mapped to DevTest roles, why do I need the users in DevTest?
You need users in DevTest because you control access to features in DevTest. LDAP is all, what it is doing, like that's why I was talking about authentication and authorization, right? So LDAP is only providing authentication. In LDAP, you don't control access to DevTest features, right? So in DevTest, you have different features. We spoke about the different roles, that is. So each role has access to different features. This control is not there in LDAP. LDAP is only authenticating user. This is where you authorize users to use certain features. All that is controlled in DevTest. That is why you need them to work together and integrate. You cannot take this out of DevTest. So the role access, everything is still controlled in DevTest. I hope that makes sense. Did that answer your question? I don't know if you can provide
a Stefan, if you have any additional questions, you can just put them into the Q&A box and we'll try to clarify as best as possible. You can also feel free to reach out after the session too.
Absolutely. I think I'll display my email ID and you can reach out to me. On communities, I'm there, so you can reach out there also.
Okay, that's it for now. Do you have any more slides to go through?
That's all.
Okay, so we'll continue to pause for another minute or two. If anyone has any questions, please feel free to enter them into the Q&A box in the bottom right-hand corner. And at this point, we'll also open it up to verbal questions. So if you have a question you'd like to ask over the phone, you can click #6 on your telephone keypad to unmute yourself, and then you can go ahead and ask any questions you have. So let's give it another minute or two for people to chime in if they have any additional questions. We have another one into the chat box from Stefan. So I assign permissions to roles, and the roles are mapped to the users of LDAP groups. Where are the users needed?
You need users because you are assigning. Okay, so see, LDAP groups, you are assigning to roles, but then, you can control it at user level. You remember there's another question that was asked. Now, within an LDAP group, can I control access to the users? It's not a group that, you can add roles to a group, but then it's individual users whom you control the access at. So you have the flexibility of changing the roles at individual user level. That's why you need users in DevTest. And, this is basically, of course, you're doing LDAP integration, but you're forgetting that, in basically DevTest, it's always users and roles. That's how you maintain. So you still have control within even though you have multiple users of within a LDAP group which is mapped to a DevTest role, you can still change at individual user level. So that's the flexibility that it provides, and you can have individual. That's why you need the users.
Okay. Any other questions, guys? Okay, well, if that's it on questions, I'm going to go ahead and launch a poll. I always put this poll at the end of webcasts because I like to see what you guys think about the topic of the webcast, and we take your feedback and use that to build out future webcasts, so please take a second and respond to that. As we said, if you have any additional questions that you think of later, you can always reach out to either of us, or you can post a question in the DevTest community. We always have people looking on there to see any questions that come in and respond in a timely manner. We also have a few upcoming dev test webcasts. We have one on the HP ALM integration, custom pattern matching as well, and we also have a user group conference coming up for our European customers. So if you're interested in any of those events, you can head to the dev test community. They're located in the top right-hand corner of the page, and you can RSVP to any of those that you're interested in. Thank you so much, Surya. The presentation today was great, and we had a lot of questions, so there seems to be quite a bit of interest in this. So thank you so much, everyone, for joining. We appreciate it, and we will talk to you on the communities. Have a great day, everyone.
Thank you. Thanks, everyone.